This is pretty interesting. Let me see what this has here. This is kind of getting me ticked off.
Windows 8?
No, it's this whole Sandy Hook. Well, first, you know, we discussed the conspiracy theorists who say that it was all set up by the government so they could start clamping down and getting our guns. Well, it turns out that the father of one of the children who died went to a hearing in Hartford, Connecticut, and they say that he was heckled by pro-gun advocates of the NRA when he went to talk about...
I've seen the video.
Well, apparently he wasn't heckled, and MSNBC doctored the video so that the audio sounded like they were heckling him.
No, here's the problem, okay? He was speaking to... Who was he speaking to?
He went to a hearing in Hartford with lawmakers and lobbyists.
Okay. This is a public hearing. This is not an opportunity for you to scream out from the back. He asked a question. It wasn't maybe the smartest thing to do. The chair of that committee should have told him, do not ask a rhetorical question of the audience. And I've seen it. It was a very open-ended question. Not well phrased on his part, but at the same time, you know what, the guy, he basically was like, why would anybody need that? Nobody can answer this question. And he kind of turned around and looked. The problem is, if you go to a city commission meeting, they will toss your ass out for that. Okay? You don't get to have, something from the back of the room.
Mike, that's not it. That is not what this story is about. It is about MSNBC editing that appearance to make it sound like pro-gun people were heckling him at this thing, and they weren't.
I'm talking about what actually happened, okay?
I'm talking about a news organization altering the news to push an agenda. That's what this story is about. And Anderson Cooper of CNN...
Well, hey, come on. They didn't build that? This is exactly what the media does. They do it all the time. They take something, they
this
take
is
it
what
out
the
of
story
context,
is about.
And blow it apart.
No, you can take something out of context, but when you intentionally edit something to make it something that it's not, Mike, that's not news. That's propaganda.
Well, that's what we have. We have propaganda businesses instead of the news.
This is what I'm talking about. This is the story.
I haven't seen.
I know you saw the clip.
No, I saw the actual clip. I have not actually seen any stories on MSNBC or anywhere else that was about
Anderson Cooper from CNN also ran with that angle until it was pointed out to him how heavily edited the clip was, and he took the clip down from his site.
Okay.
So this is what I'm getting at. I'm not talking about free speech. I'm not talking about people heckling him. I'm talking about a news organization, someone that is supposed to be providing news, taking something and saying, I can make something else out of this.
Well, it's just basically taking the clip out of context.
It's editing.
Yes, context.
I could tell you that the wall is purple, and you can take it out of context, Mike.
No, the wall's either purple or the wall's not purple.
So you can take it out of context and make it something else, but don't edit what I'm saying. This is clear. This is just blatant lies. That's what the story's about.
Okay. I'm not arguing with you. I have not seen the story. And I think I've made that pretty clear.
Well, that's what I'm talking about. That's why I'm bringing up the story now.
I understand, but what I'm saying to you...
You saw the unedited version on television.
No, I did see an edited version. I did not see his total remarks. I saw him begin to speak, and he had a picture of his kid.
Yes.
And he was sitting there. And then they kind of skipped forward, and this was a YouTube video, and they skipped forward, and he was asking some questions about why does anybody need these weapons? Why? Not one person can tell me why. My point was the committee chairman should have said, do not address your remarks to the audience.
Address your remarks
to us. But at the same time, those guys who started talking in the back of the room were out of line as well. I'm not talking about the editing. I'm not talking about anything.
I know, but that's why I don't want you to talk about it. I'm talking about this story about a news organization that took what you heard and spliced it to make it something completely different. That's the story.
Okay, it happens all the time, man. It happens.
So what? We shouldn't talk about it?
No, I'm saying it's not.
Nobody should be angry about this?
It's not as big a deal. I'm not saying it's
not a big deal?
No, it's not. It's not.
Okay. All right. We're done. We are done. It's not a big deal.
It's not a big deal. I see it done on news shows all day.
And you just accept it.
Well,
they wore you down.
I don't like it. I don't like it.
Do something.
What do you suggest that we should do?
Hey, we're doing it now.
And what are we doing?
We're bringing it forward. People who are listening to this show will also have an opinion on the matter.
And that's fine. Everybody's entitled to their opinion. I'm not saying that they're not.
Okay, Mike. You're missing the overall point. You're just saying it happens. I accept it. Let's move on.
Okay. Why does this story bother you more than other stories where it happens in the news?
Because they got caught red-handed, and it's been pointed out.
They've been caught red-handed plenty of times before.
No, Mike, they haven't. Well, give me an example, Mike.
You didn't build that. We just had this conversation, okay? The fact is that the media clipped that,
yeah,
that speech.
Yeah, why do we tolerate it?
Why do we tolerate it?
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
Okay, so I'm helpless. I'm helpless.
No,
everybody listening is helpless, and we're just minions,
it.
And we're lemmings, and we just got to put up with it.
I didn't say that. You said that. I just said...
No, what are you going to do about it, Mike?
I said I'm aware of it. That's all I can make myself.
I'm aware of it, too, and I'm making other people aware of it.
And that's fine. Who's arguing with you about making anybody aware of it?
No one's arguing with me about it.
Okay, then what are we disagreeing about?
You're saying it just happens all the time,
I'm saying it does happen.
Thus what? Okay, so why do we allow it to happen all the time?
You have to make yourself aware. You can't have one source of news. You've got to have multiple sources of news.
Okay. So
that's your responsibility.
So
what should
MSNBC do?
Well, for starters, they should apologize if they did this.
They're not going to.
What do you mean they're not going to?
There's nothing, there's no comment from them whatsoever that they have any intention of doing anything about it.
Okay.
Well, okay. So we just move on. They got away with it.
Yeah. Media companies get away with this kind of crap all the time. It happens. But you know what? If you believe all the news that you hear from MSNBC, then you're a fool. If you believe all the news that you hear from Fox, you're a fool.
And CNN?
CNN, you're a fool. You've got to fact check.
So where do we as Americans get information from?
Well, you've got to look.
What is our trusted source?
There is no such thing anymore.
Well, there you go.
Unfortunately, because the media has become so much about the money, the news divisions don't even, you know, the news divisions didn't used to have to worry about ratings. Now they do. And they do stupid stuff like this, and they do it all the time. I'm not condoning it.
What was their agenda? What was their intent by editing it? What do you think they were trying to convey?
I can't climb inside their head and tell you what they were thinking when they did it.
So it just happens, and you just got to bite your tongue and move on.
I went and saw the video, okay? I went and I watched the video. When I heard about the story, I went and watched the video. What anybody else has to say about it doesn't really concern me one way or the other. You have got to seek out the facts for yourself. You've got to use multiple sources. You can't just rely on someone's word. Is it wrong? Yeah, apparently it is. If it's dead wrong and the story is completely backwards, it is what it is. But that's not a public forum for everybody to have something to say from the cheap seats. This was a committee meeting in front of whoever you said was there, lawmakers and law enforcement people. He was speaking to that committee. Now, he made a mistake when he asked a rhetorical, open-ended question to the crowd.
Right, fine.
Okay? But that doesn't mean that they were right to open their yaps.
No, MSNBC took two sound bites and mixed it together to make it sound like somebody was being heckled.
Well, I've seen the actual video.
Right.
Okay? As much of it as
And you
I
know he
find.
Wasn't heckled.
No, he asked.
So we have a major broadcaster, MSNBC. This is not some tiny little crappy show in Bradenton, Florida. This is a very big network that pays millions of dollars to their hosts. And it is what it is. And somebody went and edited a news story, a father who lost a child.
Sure.
And they turned it into, we have to put a spin on this to make it look like the NRA heckled this guy. Let's take well, what
I
happened.
I haven't heard anything in the story that you mentioned about the NRA.
Yeah, maybe, gun supporters. Gun it. Supporters. Yes. Yeah, okay. they were members of the. They have card carrying members of the NRA. They were the right. ones sitting in the back.
Okay.
So someone did that, and this network broadcast it, and just zero responsibility.
All mistakes get made all the time. I'm not.
Miss Mike, it was intentionally done. It wasn't a mistake. Okay. They edited it.
What?
Kurt, they did it on purpose. There was no mistake,
okay.
Mike.
Stop for 1 second. What do you want done? Instead of asking me what I want to do about it, what do you want done?
I want people to know. I want this. I want them to suffer. You know what? If you can make a fast food restaurant suffer by going there and kissing somebody, if you can hit them with their advertisers and do that, do it with them too.
Well, go ahead. Start a movement.
Yes.
Get jiggy with it.
That's what I'm talking about, Mike.
Okay.
I'm talking about blatant propaganda, Mike. That's what I'm talking about. Blatant propaganda.
And what I have said consistently about this, and I've said right here in the last 5 minutes, is it goes on from all sides all day.
Yeah.
You give me that blank look, but I don't
know.
No,
there's no
why.
Blank look. It's just you just resigned yourself to like this is just the way it is.
I'm not resigning myself to anything.
What are you going to do about it? I told you what I'm going to do. What are you going to do? Nothing.
I'm not going to start marching on MSNBC's offices, but I didn't march on Fox's offices when I saw them doing things. You know what? You want to get up in arms about something with the media? How about these wars that we got going on in Iraq and Afghanistan where these guys got the comic earlier was talking about these
right.
guys that are getting their asses blown to bits.
Absolutely.
Okay, what are you doing about it? What are you doing about it?
What am I doing about it?
Nothing.
Nothing.
That's right, because you've accepted it, right?
No, well, yes
yeah.
or no.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, it goes both ways. No, none of us have the ability to fix everything in this society. You have to make yourself as aware as you can, as aware as you can be able by finding multiple sources for your stories. You cannot believe what one news organization or another says. Just because you saw it there doesn't mean that you can say, oh, that's it. It's got to be true. Okay, you go out and you do some investigation. Go to YouTube, find the actual clip, watch the clip. I know exactly what happened. I'm not defending MSNBC, but I've watched the clip,
well,
and I know exactly what happened.
In a sense, you're letting them get away with it.
How? First of all,
they broadcast it, and they're not being their feet are not
stop.
Being held to the fire, Mike.
First of all, to insinuate that I've let them get away with it is to insinuate that I had some control over it one way or the other, which I damn sure did not.
So you have zero control over any of the media.
Do you have control over the media?
I don't know. If we can shut down fast food joints because
they
don't believe in gay marriage.
Which ones have been shut down?
You know?
Last I checked, you can still get a Chick-fil-A anywhere you want. Nobody's been shut down.
No, but you can punish them financially, can't you?
How do you punish them by not buying
You boycott.
Their
you boycott.
Wait a second. Hold
You're trying
on.
To tell me none of these boycotts have
I'll,
had any
you know
effect?
What I saw their drive-thrus full to the brim. I saw them get more business out of that than I saw them lose.
So what? So we're completely powerless. So when people, if somebody in the editing room wants to edit a story and make something that is completely fictitious, something that did not happen, there's no responsibility. No one is held responsible.
How will you hold them responsible? That's my question.
But is somebody responsible, Mike?
Are you asking me a question?
Mike, a big giant corporation just
edited video?
No.
Is someone responsible?
If you want to put it in those terms, absolutely not. Nobody's responsible. You know why? Because corporations are people, and they're going to get away with everything they feel like getting away with. Now, what are you going to do about
that? What the hell does that mean? You're not making any sense. It's a corporate. It's just a news organization who completely altered the news. Yeah. And they got caught doing it. You're saying no one should be held accountable for this.
I thought that battery died.
Yeah, I think he's enjoying this myself. Look, man, do I like the way the world is sometimes? No, I don't.
That wasn't the question. The question was, should someone be held accountable?
Who are you going to hold accountable?
Should someone be held accountable?
For
this complete fabrication, this basically a lie, this misinformation that was broadcast as a news story, but really wasn't.
Okay, and how will we do it?
You didn't answer the question again. Should someone be held accountable?
Should someone be held accountable?
In this company, yes.
I have no idea. I'm not a corporation. I don't speak for corporations. Love that. I don't know what you're looking for. It's like you,
okay.
It's like you have a
no. I'm asking. No, I'm asking you such a. You know, forget about MSNBC. Walmart.
Yes.
Does something. They lie in their advertising.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. They lie. Whatever they did, they'll lie about something. Whatever. It's a stone cold lie, and they get caught red handed.
Mm-hmm.
Should someone in the Walmart Corporation be held responsible?
It's a theoretical question. The answer, my hypothetical answer, is yes.
Someone should be.
My real world answer is no, because corporations don't get nailed for crap in this country, and we both know it. They don't get made responsible for anything they do.
So if Coca-Cola bottles poison,
it's a different story.
Should someone be held responsible?
It's a different story to alter the news as it is to poison people. It's a false equivalency.
Okay, fine. All right, Coca-Cola sells you a 12-ounce can, but it's really 11.
Hey, Subway's selling you 12-foot-long subs.
Should they be held responsible?
I just bought one the other day.
But I walked in. But is it truth? Is it truthful?
Well, no, it's not truthful.
It's not truthful. So you really weren't paying for a foot-long sub. Should someone in that company be held responsible?
Well,
because that is their advertising.
Who?
They lure you in by telling you you can get a foot-long sub, but you're not getting one.
I understand, but who? Who? You've got to have a name. You've got to have a person to hold responsible. This is
no, forget about it. It's anybody, whoever concocted the foot-long.
That would be whoever invented the inch. An inch is 12.
So it's whoever baked the bread.
Well, it's...
Somebody, you're saying they should just get away with it. Who cares?
I'm not saying they should get away with it. The only way I can make them pay personally is not to buy their sandwich. It's the only recourse I have. If you don't like MSNBC, if you think they're lying and full of crap, don't watch their stuff. Same goes for Fox, same goes for CNN, same goes for CBS, ABC, all of them.
No, just don't watch.
Do you have another option that I don't
know? Yeah, I think somebody should be fired.
Well, that's entirely possible that someone could be fired.
That's all I've been asking you for 20 minutes now. Should someone be held responsible?
Well, no, you just said fired just now. You said
that's me. That's my opinion. I was asking you your opinion. I said, should this company be held responsible for the misinformation they're broadcasting?
I think they all should be held responsible for the things that they say over the public airwaves.
There you go.
I don't have a problem with that.
So someone in that company, whether it's the lowest man on the totem pole or the CEO.
No, not the lowest man on the totem pole.
Or the CEO.
The lowest man on the totem pole.
I'm giving you the entire corporate structure. Somebody in that organization needs to have their feet held to the fire because of this false story. Someone needs to pay for this.
Somebody at the top, not somebody at the
bottom.
Well,
that's just your opinion.
No. No, the guy at the bottom, and you know this as well as anybody, the guy at the bottom has absolutely no responsibility for what goes on here. This is all driven from the top down, not from the bottom up. So, no, do I want to see the guy who actually did the reporting on the story? get killed? No, because it's not necessarily his responsibility. It's a producer. We talked about this a few weeks ago with
somebody approved that story to be aired.
We talked this about a few weeks ago with a guy named Rob Parker on ESPN. Okay, went on ESPN, and he made a bunch of derogatory comments about Robert Griffin III.
Yeah.
Called him a cornball brother. They fired him. The producers of
somebody.
Somebody.
For a good example, Mike, somebody was held responsible.
The guy
may not be the guy you wanted, but someone had their feet held to the fire. Bingo. There were repercussions for what that guy said.
Yes, there were.
There were no repercussions as of yet for MSNBC editing something and taking something completely out of creating a fictitious news story.
Okay. If that's the way you see it, that's fine. I don't disagree with you.
Caller, hurry up. We only got 2 minutes.
Yeah, come on.
That is great radio.
See, I wish we'd do this all the
time. See, I don't want to argue at 8 o'clock at night. I want to do it.
When nobody's listening at 10 to 11.
Is that it? Hello? Are you there?
Already gone. Look, man, I don't disagree with you. When somebody does something stupid,
yes, you
but
do.
There are levels.
No, I want to do is ask you a question, and you just dance around it all the time.
No, it's not dance
Should
around.
Someone be held responsible? Hey, man, this happens all the time. Okay? Should someone be held responsible? Hey, this is just the way it is. Corporations are this and that. Should someone be held responsible?
Okay.
What does okay mean?
Yes.
Okay, there you go. That's all I wanted.
There you go.
20 freaking minutes, you bastard.
Hey, no problem.
20 minutes.
Hey, we had to kill this last 20 minutes.
Yes,
somehow.
We did. I miss.
So how will we?
I miss it? Patty Andrews already.
How will we hold these people responsible? This is the question.
Hey, listen, folks. We only got a minute left, and
come on, we got time. Let's do it.
Shut up. I got to talk about WWPM.